How's it going, fellow indie game enthusiast? I hope you're having a great day and you're ready for some Souls-like Metroidvania Dark Fantasy action, because today we are playing Tearscape demo version. As a hunter, you explore a dark, interconnected world filled with dungeons, relying on precise combat to survive. Battle grotesque monsters, expand your arsenal, and uncover hidden paths in a non-linear pixel art journey. The game has everything I am looking for: precise combat, Souls-like / Metroidvania, dark fantasy, grotesque stuff, and expanding arsenal. And of course, pixel art. So without further ado, let's jump into the game of Tearscape and let's see how the demo version plays. But before we press start, please write down in the comments, what do you think about Tearscape so far? A few days ago, I had to send back my gaming rig for some repairs, so the meanwhile I dusted off my old laptop. But of course, at the time, I wanted to play some newer games. Thankfully, I partnered up with Boosteroid, so I was able to play newer games on my laptop without any problems. Boosteroid is a cloud gaming service that allows you to play your favorite games on different hardwares no matter where you are. Games launch on high-end remote gaming rigs and gameplay is getting streamed to you. No additional downloads or updates and no session time limits. To get the maximum out of Boosteroid, you will need to have a decent internet connection and you need to have said game in your library. If you don't have a high-end machine and you like to play newer games, Boosteroid is a really great choice for you. If you sign up through my link in the description, you also help out the channel a lot. Thank you very much, Boosteroid, for teaming up with me. And now, back to the game. Okay, no intro and no WASD controls. We are using the arrow keys. Wow, pretty retro stuff. With the space, we can hit, and is there a way to, like, okay, with shift we can do some rolling. Look at how the stamina is going down. It's pretty precise, but I shouldn't spam like this. Okay, and we hit, also stamina is going down. The game does not have any music. Oh boy. Full screen, we sync, yes, music volume is on 100 and we do not have any music. Maybe comes later. Who knows? How to interact. Press the roll shift button to roll. In combat, you get a small window of invincibility while rolling. You can roll over some small gaps. Okay. Oh, sorry. Okay. No, shift also interacts with stuff. So, okay, I can roll through this one. Really cool. We need a key for this. Okay. I have this button that is being stuck type of stuff. You can break chests by attacking them using the attack space button. Ooh, okay. So this doesn't need a key. Oh, it has a key. You found a small key. Use it to unlock the path. Really cool. I guess we cannot take down rocks. Okay, cool. And now we go there, unlock the chest. Awesome. So you don't have to click anything, you just go there and the key is getting added automatically. Ooh boy. Maybe he doesn't want to fight, he's just, you know, moving to hug us. Unfortunately, no. Okay, another one. Use interact enter button to pick up pots. Use attack space button to throw them. Cool. So with enter, I can pick up them. And with space, woo, nice. Oh, okay, that's a pit, not a rug. Awesome, okay. Another pit, ooh, okay. So if you roll through it, it just falls down, really cool. So enter, and can I throw this? Oh yes, definitely. Clever usage of the environment. Bam, really cool. Two hits. Can we strike? Yes, of course we can do that. We can strike those pots, and some of them are containing good things. Whoops. No, no, no. Oh, I forgot to press shift. Okay. Press heal, the X button, to drink one healing flask. Okay. No taking down bushes or anything like that. Okay, now we have music. Cool. Woo. I was kind of concerned for a second, but maybe in the tomb or whatever. What's that? There's no music. Whoops, okay. At last you arrive. What kept you? Your next target's location eludes us still, but the organization persists in this search. Venture north. A graveyard is besieged by vile monsters. Pass through it with resolve. Our path they cross again once I possess further information. You are dismissed. So he looks like a plague doctor slash bird. So he's a plague doctor bird, in my opinion. Really cool path. Music is kinda funky. Whoops, okay. Cool. Okay, we can spam the attack button. That's also really nice. I'm not going to use potion until we have like the most optimal usage for them. So I'm just waiting. I'm wondering, are there any like hidden paths that we can take? I really like the rolling animation. It's pretty awesome. Here comes the sad boy, zombie, whatever. Okay. Some mushrooms, foliage is really nice. Controls are also really cool. Pretty responsive. They're going... No. We're there. No, okay. That's not the falling down stuff. Progress is automatically saved when you interact with the checkpoint. Using rest replenishes all your health and flask, but respawns all enemies. Okay, classic souls. Like, level up allows you to increase your character stats in exchange for tears. Oh boy, tears, of course. That's the checkpoint again. Edgiest stuff I've seen this week. Really cool. Okay, bunch of enemies. Let's go. Smack them. Music is really cool. Kind of out of place, in my opinion. I thought it's going to be like more dark fantasy, like oh, type of choirs and stuff, but also really cool. Can we take down the graves? Any interaction with the graves? No, unfortunately, no. Candles. Ooh, we can take down the candles. Awesome. Awesome idea. Okay, let's pick up the pot. And just throw at... Poor guy. Ooh, with a stick. Zombie with a stick. Okay, now I'm going to heal. Ooh, really cool animation. Really cool sound. Huge fan of retro stuff. Just feels... honest, you know. I don't know why. Feels much more honest than most of the recent games out there. I know this is a pretty recent game, but the feeling is definitely brings me back to like classic old times. Playing games on my DOS computer at my grandparents' house. Prince of Persia, Lotus, some kind of flipper stuff. It was really great. Okay, so these are looking kind of bad, but that's just... some decoration. I thought these are monsters, but no. Fortunately, no. Okay. Zombie guys. Another. So that's tier. Okay, so I thought this is money. We're picking up money, but why would we pick up silver coins from zombies? They don't need money. They don't use money. But they are crying. Oh boy. Ooh, that was so close. Oh boy. Okay. Nasty zombie guy. Okay. So they are crying and we are gathering their tears. Pretty edgy. I like it. Ooh. Some call tropes type of stuff or like spikes. Now call tropes are different. Sorry. Oh, we need the key. Oh boy. We need the other direction. Okay, we have to take the other direction, which is... So some of these are broken, but can we take down the broken ones? Unfortunately, no. Okay. Is there a map, by the way? For example, with tab? No. Oh boy. That's kind of sad. Let's see if we can go this way. because there was a chest that contained the key. And seemingly the entrance was... not here. Okay. Let's go on. Haven't been here, I guess. This direction. Yes, because we have untouched candles. Okay. Ooh, we can get to the corner of the pit and we are not falling down. Really cool. Can we take down these, by the way? No, unfortunately. They look like candles. Ooh, look at this. Like a lift or some kind of elevator. No! Oh boy. So we cannot roll through there? Why is that? Or maybe if you're positioning the roll, yes, correctly, we can go there. Awesome. Another roll. Take this down. Ooh, what is this? Huge amount of tears. No, no, no. Ooh, I pressed the wrong button. Oh. Okay, the game is really generous. Oh boy, why am I doing this? Okay, let's just roll. Use the last potion. Is this a possible way? Yes. Okay, bunch of candles, so hopefully we can get some HP back. Kinda sad that we cannot desecrate those graves, like they are already broken a bit, so it would be nice. Some kind of cool loot out of them. Or maybe a different weapon. Can take them down later on. Who knows? Okay, so zero potions, because I fell down a few times. Let's see. If we can find like another checkpoint or something. It would be pretty cool. Okay. Some enemies. Oh, no hearts. Damn it. Okay. Okay, so they are trying to come at us diagonally, so it's not the easiest way to attack them or nuke them down. Clever zombies, for sure. Uh-huh. Okay, get it. Aha, uh-huh, so that's... I don't know, water? Is it water, by the way? Who knows? Okay, there's a chest. No! Damn it. Okay. Nuke it down. Awesome. Dig this down. We have a key. You find a small key. Use it to unlock the path. Or a path, sorry. Wait, so... Okay, we can just go there. Okay, you found a piece of the map. Oh, yes. How to... But I think we cannot use the map right now. Oops. Timed the roll badly. So wait a second. Like... Now. Cool. So I can take, like, two hits. Two more hits. Jeez. Okay. That's going to be problematic. But, hopefully... No. Damn it. Okay. So a new zombie. Yes. Cool. So we have to go back to the same spot because there was a door. A locked door. That needed a key. Yes. We've been here before. And I guess this was the part where we go down. Unlock the door. Or sorry, the... Yeah, it was a door, I guess. For some reason, this music reminds me of a jungle. But this effect is not a jungle. Yes! And what about this one? Yes, more tears. So maybe I used it wrongly because we needed this to unlock the path. But what I cannot afford is dying at the moment. So what I'm going to do is going back to the checkpoint. Hopefully leveling up because we have 36 tiers. So hopefully that's enough. So some of the map is pretty similar. Some parts of the map are pretty similar, but I think I know where I'm going at the moment. So hopefully if I just go out here, the checkpoint will be... Yes! Really cool. So interact with the checkpoint, rest and level up. Awesome. Attack. And, well, that's it. We used all of it, and now we rest. Pretty awesome. Okay. So there is no way to unlock this gate at the moment. But we know where to go, so... Wait a second. So the thing is... Maybe for a better progress, I just farm some of these guys. Ooh, we can still get them. They're in the radius of the swing. Pretty cool. So, you know, I just go down. I kinda know where to go. Oh, no. Oh, we do not have a key. Damn it. So, I just... Wait. So, is it respawning, by the way? Oh, yeah. All of them are respawning. So... I just have to go back, get the key once again. And, well, unlock the path that I know where to go now. Cool. Okay, we take down those enemies on the way. Get some tears. Wait. Okay. Hopefully I remember the path. Yeah, from here we go to the right. So that's definitely a game that feels like you can play, or you would have played this with your friend, sitting before the same computer and trying to help, you know, each other to navigate and stuff. Like, no, that's not the way. Oh, go up there, go right there. So I'm pretty sure this one is inspired heavily by, not Dark Souls, but, you know, which is the... BloodBorne. Yes. In my opinion, this was inspired heavily by BloodBorne. If you check the character, by the way, the main character we are playing. Garb of the character looks pretty similar to BloodBorne. Starting gear. Okay, we're almost there to get... extra level. Whoops. Okay, so I think we need 26. Yes. Cool, that's a heart. Oh, awesome. No. It was not. It was the direction I turned back from. This is where the key is. If I, no. Oh boy. Kinda mistaken this. Cool, we have 26 to level up. So will the chest be there, by the way? Or chest. Chests won't respawn. Yeah, seemingly no. So we're just going to take that path. The untaken path. And let's see what happens. I think it was... here, yes. Pretty spooky. Oops, okay. Careful with the edges. Huh? Awesome. Chest, another chest, okay. Come on guys. You know what's going to happen, yes. Uh-huh, okay. So roll. Another roll, and I guess that's a key. Yes. Use it to unlock the path. So, chests are not respawning. So we need to find another chest. So wait a second, the path was blocked. Oh boy, where was it? Into the left. But maybe we are going to the same place. Even if we go that way. So we are going in circles. Or no. Oh boy, that's just a path that already took. Never mind. Let's just go back. It was going down. No. So that was this hidden one. And it contained some tears, if I remember correctly. But that's not the main path. Oops, okay. Edges are kind of tricky. So sometimes you cannot see them properly. Or they feel like that you are not going down if you go close to them. But seemingly that's not the case. Yeah, that's a dead end. Okay. Just some extra tears. Oh boy, okay. So from the altar. Oh, okay. And hearts not disappearing. Okay, that's pretty cool. So we can just get them. And just take them out and we can wait if we need them. Maybe that was the path? No. But HP on max, of course. For sure. We need this. Aha, okay. That was also a dead end. Oops, okay. Well, in this case, we are going down to the part where we started. Wait, there was a blocked path, I remember. Somewhere here. Still no, like, M. Nah, sure. No map, of course. There's the HP. Uh-huh. Maybe it was here. Oh, yes. It is here, definitely. Okay, path unlocked. I guess if we die, we lose all the tears. So maybe that's quite a bit risky stuff going on. But we have a bunch of potions, max HP. So shouldn't be a problem. Whee! Of course. Oh, we can see. Oh, we can see the stick of the enemy. Pretty cool. Just stop there and like waiting for us. Get a stick out. Okay, that's maybe not the proper way to say. Okay. Took them. Wow. Oh, we've been here. Wait a second. So I unlocked this path. Because they are just... Okay, we are going down, I guess. Yes, look at this. We can take down flowers. Nice stuff. So, for example, a checkpoint. Ooh, look at this. Pretty nasty stuff. So, maybe a checkpoint, please, game. Ooh, spikes. Okay. Looks kind of ominous, if you ask me. Ah, of course, that's a boss. Okay. So this is going to be brutal. Okay, we need X to drink a potion. Oh boy, okay. Oh man. You cannot roll through them. Seemingly, you died. Ooh, look at the pixelated death stuff. And yeah. lost all of the stuff, so no level up, no anything. But if we go back there, by the way, our stuff will be there, I guess. Wait, wait, where did I... How did I go there? Like this, I guess. No, no, no. So we cannot roll through the enemy's model. We have to roll away from it. So in this case, we can get out of the attack. Okay. Okay, we get some HP, hopefully, from the candles. Yes. Almost full. No, okay. That should be fine. So I just have to remind myself that do not roll into the enemy's body. Just roll away. It shouldn't be a problem. But he has one giant axe for sure. Whoops. Damn it. I forgot about the spikes. Well. Ooh, okay, cool. Bushes, taking bushes. Oh yes. Nice one. Okay, so let's see. Pretty mad, I guess. So we need to roll, because the game said at the beginning you have a pretty nice window of opportunity if you roll. Haha, not like this. Okay, we were able to make the same progress just like before. Okay, now we know that maybe we should wait with this. So we are just going back. There. There. Okay. And there's a path to south that I'm going to take right now. But of course, our stuff is where the boss is. So big question. Is it like every Dark Souls game that I just go there and the boss arena just closes down and I cannot leave? Or can I get my stuff from the boss? Yes, we can get the stuff from the boss. And I can leave. Okay, that's a really cool thing. So now we are going south. Did it. Oh boy. Bunch of enemies. Maybe. So maybe we need some levels to take down the boss a bit easier, because we get more HP. Stuff. Ooh, look at this. Bunch of things to destroy. I like this. Desecrating some flowers in the graveyard. That's dark fantasy as hell. Okay. Awesome. So is this a crypt we can go down? No. Unfortunately, no. Huge grave. Okay. I just have to take down these. Okay, cool. Let's leave those hearts there. Oh, so wait a second. So technically I can do like a go out, hit the boss, go there, get the other like parts, go back there. Ooh, what is that? Uh-oh. Ooh, boy. Come on. Okay, that's nasty. Oh boy, I died. It's also laughing. Oh boy, okay. So now that we know this guy is pretty annoying, let's just go back there. We know all the shenanigans happening there. So we're just rolling. Here's the dude. Three attacks. Rolling away. Annoyingly placed a trap. On purpose, I guess. Okay. No hearts right now. But here, they have a bunch, so I just know that. And let's go to the... Oh boy. Come on, how to hit this? That's pretty annoying. Oh, cool. Okay. So we need to corner it somehow. That was really bad. Okay. Okay, not always the same, like, flowers give you hearts. Really cool. Come on. Wow! Does not have a maximum range. Okay, that's annoying. Okay, what I'm going to do is get my tears. Go back, take down those zombies. Cool. Oh. Get back with... no. I'm just going to go back and... some levels, because I think we need some upgrade for sure, and then we will see how we can, I don't know, try to take down the boss or something. Really cool. Uh-huh. To the left, up and then down, and we are at the shrine. Come on. Come on, okay, give me your tears so I can upgrade more stuff, hopefully. So at least one level, for sure. Okay, level up. Vitality. And, cost 27. You know, more attacks, why not? Let's rest. Oh, it's interesting because rest will, you know, respawn enemies, but leveling up, not necessarily. So, I guess resting... So leveling up does not require resting. So just like in, I don't know, any Dark Souls stuff, if you rest... Oh, sorry, level up. It counts as a rest, so... aha, okay, now we need two attacks. Okay, I remember this. Vaguely. Okay, let's see what happens if we try to take down the boss now. Because we are dealing more damage. And of course I'm trying to... Aha! If I just go up and not, like, classically... Whoops. Yes, okay, awesome. So technically wasn't a boss, or was it a boss? Who knows? Will they like respawn? Okay, cool. Look like a giant angry bear. A teddy bear with a huge two-handed axe. Sounds great. Okay, so two hits to the zombies. I guess with the next upgrade we can one-hit them. Which is really awesome. So let's see those pesky bugs. Hopefully I can understand them now. Okay, we have to wait until they roll, I guess. Come on. Okay, that's not funny. What am I missing? So I was able to take down the boss without a single hit, because I understood that you have to roll upwards or downwards, so away from the angle of the attack. What's with this pesky bug stuff? Okay, maximum HP, thank you, flowers. No, I have to... Oh boy. Okay, cool. So we need to hit it when it is resting. This. Come on. Or maybe we should get closer to a wall. And when it comes, we just, I don't know, roll away. Come, come, my friend. Come, 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 come. We know you want this. Of course you want this. A piece of this. Oh boy. No, 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 no. Oh boy, of course. Oh, I... Oh boy. I wasn't able to get healed. Oh, man. That was problematic. Okay. So I think we kind of understand how the game plays. And it's extremely fun. The game looks pretty cool. I really like this pixel art stuff. Music is kind of like tribally for me, not spooky enough, but that's just a minor thing. Enemies are really cool. The boss was extremely great. I really like how the combat works, zombies and all the cool stuff. Like, they kind of put like classic adventuring elements into like go this, find that key to unlock that part, to unlock that part, but also combined with the classic like soulslike leveling up, resting, all the enemies are coming back type of thing. So if you're interested in games like this, Tearscape is a really cool way to start, and the demo version is free, of course, on Steam. So if you like it, link is in the description, and check it out and have a blast with it yourself. Thank you very much for today. I was The Alchemist, and I'm seeing you with more awesome indie game gameplays extremely soon. Take care.